In this series of OpsLogix how-to videos, we'll be showing you how to monitor VMware for Service Providers and System Center Operations Manager 2012 and 2016 versions. First, you'll need to set up a SCOM management group, then import the OpsLogix VMware management packs, configure the SCOM resource pool, and finally add the VMware environment to be monitored. Once you have access to the customer download area, you can download the VMware management pack. Assuming you have already done that and you already have a SCOM management group ready, we'll get started with importing the OpsLogix VMware management pack. Once you have downloaded the source files of the VMware management pack, unzip the files. Click on the management pack folder and copy the path towards it. Next, open the SCOM console. Click on Administration, then click on Management Packs. Here, we will select the Import Management Packs option. Click on Add, then click on Add from Disk and select No when the Online Catalog Connection pop-up is shown. Paste the folder path you've copied earlier, select all the files and click Open. Double-check if all files are shown in the import list. Everything should be fine. Then click Install. This will allow all VMware management packs to be imported into your SCOM management group. After importing the OpsLogix VMware management pack files, the next step will be to apply the correct licenses. Open the SCOM console if you haven't already done that. Then go to Monitoring. There you'll find a folder with the name OpsLogix. When you open that folder, you should see the OpsLogix licensing dashboard. As you can see, there are no licenses present yet. To apply the correct licenses, go to Add Key. Once you have gained access to our customer download area, our sales team has already sent you all the licenses that you need. Copy-paste the key that you have received and click on Import Licenses. After completing these steps, all licenses will be enabled. Once the importing of the keys has succeeded, you will see a list in the licensing dashboard, indicating how many devices are licensed and when it will expire. After the license key import, the next step is to configure the SCOM resource pool. The resource pool is important because all of its members are responsible for the monitoring of your VMware servers. Open the SCOM console. Go to the Administration pane and select the resource pools. Here, we see a by default created resource pool as a result of the OpsLogix VMware Management Pack installation. However, you can also create custom-made resource pools. Normally speaking, all management servers that are members of your SCOM environment are automatically placed into this resource pool. If you wish to select a specific number of management servers, then you'll have to use the manual membership option. This will allow you to change the members of the resource pool. In this step, we will be adding the VMware environment for monitoring. In the SCOM console, go to the monitoring pane. Open the OpsLogix folder, then again the VMware folder. Click on the VMware IMP configuration dashboard. Here, select the resource pool that contains the management servers that are responsible for the VMware monitoring. Then, add the correct connection information to the VMware environment. This can be a vCenter or a vSphere server, or a directly connected ESXi or ESX host. For this demo, an IP address with a port number is used. Apply a username and a password, then click Check Connect. Behind the scene, a connection will be built from one of the members in your resource pool. After a successful connection, the SCOM console will ask you to add the VMware environment to be monitored. Choose Yes. From now on, all VMware components will be discovered and monitored by System Center Operations Manager.